اللہ کو اپنا بنا لو، اللہ کو اپنا بنا لو.
He says that there is ijma of the ummat in Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that the Sahaba Kiram, they are afdal than every other makhluk, right? So you have the Anbiya Kiram, and then you have the, you know, the highest rank after Anbiya Kiram is whom? The Sahaba Kiram of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so there is ijma of ummat on that. Now, he says that as far as the ilm and the amal is concerned, other people are also partners with the Sahaba Kiram. For example, they had the Quran, we have the Quran, they have the Hadith, we have the Hadith. And you know, some could even argue that now we have more, for example, books of a Hadith, books of knowledge than was available to them, right? Because they had the Quran and the sayings and the a'mal and of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in front of them. But in sheer, let's say, if you're calculating based on books, then you know, in 2021 you have more books and libraries and libraries of books that talk about different topics. So, as far as ilm and amal is concerned, we are sharik with the Sahaba Kiram. Then why is it that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the Sahaba Kiram that even if a person spends the likes of, like, over the worth of gold, then they cannot even get the reward that, you know, a sahabi will get for half of sa'. Sa' is like a measurement, it's like almost like a kilogram. Why is that? You know, a person doing the same amal that the sahaba karam are doing, he said that Rasulullah said that if a person does an over the worth of gold, he spends that, then he won't even get what a sahabi would get for spending just 1 kilogram. Why is that? Right? Why is that? And so the Shaykh says that this is because of the kamal of the batin that they were able to achieve. And how did they achieve it? With the suhbat of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because they had the suhbat. Now no person till the day of judgment can have the same rank as a normal sahabi. You know, and you know, we probably shouldn't say that. Normal sahabi meaning who only saw Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam once, and he passed away in the state of iman. No other person, you can have all of their amal and all of their dhikr and mujahidah and everything on one side, they cannot even come close to one of these sahabis. Why? Because they were able to achieve something that nobody else can. They were in the suhbat, in the blessed gathering, in companionship with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the kamal of batin that they were able to achieve through that, nobody else can achieve with any of their own mujahid. Right? So this is clear, right? And so this is the dalil of this kind of wilayah that you are able to get through suhbat. And then he says, because of the suhbat, their batin became enlightened. Agar awliya ummat, and if the awliya of this ummah, they were able to achieve this wealth, this treasure, this dawlat, they were able to do that because of the suhbat of their mashayikh. Why? Because the batin of these mashayikh, it also became enlightened through the batin of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Meaning this is a nisbat that comes down from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Hadith Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu or Hadith Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And because of that light that came from that chest, from that beautiful heart, into the heart of the sahabi and so on and so forth, even now people are able to enlighten their souls just by being in the sohbat of those people who were in the sohbat of their mashayikh, who were also in the sohbat of their mashayikh, all the way to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.